Fogel. Eventually to Anderson, Dryden Hunt. Worked over by Nurse, a big hit by Ekholm in the corner as Huberto's shaken up. Back on his feet though. Given Ekholm a couple of cross checks.
This is gonna get heated here. This is gonna boil over.
And here's Perry dropping the mitts.
Here we go.
So another disturbance and it's boiling over once again.
Well, you saw this coming. It was Ekholm on Huberto first. Huberto with a couple good cross checks. No arms well. And they're still having a conversation here through the linesman. I mean, gloves are up right there. And Perry once again engaged with Uyghur in that corner, who came all the way down into the mix. A willing combatant, two grizzled veterans there.
Boy, is this
surprised it didn't boil over a little bit more there, to be honest with you. I thought Ekholm was going to get up by rate, but he controls himself and doesn't go after Huberto as they talk it out instead of throw down. But obviously the second major, they would have been kicked out of the game, so that plays a big part in it. But Corey Perry, as he's done this year for the Oilers, engaged once again, trying to change the momentum for the Oilers again in this game, down by three. Some great chances on the power play for Edmonton, but Vladar was up to the task. Hyman looking for more here as this puck pops out to the front. He jams away it a couple times. Good sticks in front to break up Nugent Hopkins from a second chance. Here's the one-timer by McDavid. Just a clip of it. A little piece that is from Vladar on that sharp angle shot. This one just shot wide by Draisaitl right in the wheelhouse on a nice pass by Hyman. This is a healthy run by Kadri on Kane. He comes back, gives him a cross check. They have words going off the ice. And then here's the hit by Ekholm on Huberto. And Huberto gets up and gives him a couple solid cross checks in the number and puts the big man down. And then everybody converges in, and then Perry and Uyghur go at it. They're letting it play. Wow.
This is why everyone loves the Battle of Alberta, as the provincial rivals continue the bitterness here tonight.
Yeah, you know, you heard Kevin say, you know, you need something to kind of spark it again, right? Well, I think it's safe to say it's gotten sparked again in this game. And over the course of history between these two teams, it usually takes something like that, a lopsided affair, an aggressive battle, or some hits that people are going to question. There's been a little bit of everything in this one. The Stars have been involved physically. The role players have been involved physically, and some beautiful goals as well. And this is just mucking in the corner. Ekholm, the big man, takes down Huberto, and he was not happy with that one, so he gets up and says, okay, I can push back a little bit. And gives him a couple real solid cross checks in the numbers. And like I said, I was a little surprised Ekholm didn't get up and just say, okay, enough of that, and grab Huberto, but he doesn't. I mean, they just kind of talk, and it's been a pretty heavy battle. I think the guys are a little exhausted out there, as it's been pretty intense throughout.
And it is the Oilers who will end up with the extra minor as Matthias Ekholm pleads his case. Corey Perry getting 2 and a 5. Ekholm continuing his words for the officials. 61 seconds left in the second period, and late stages of the first, it was heating up and boiling over, and it's the same situation here. And Ron McLean said it on the panel, a playoff-like feel all around the NHL, and certainly here tonight.
Corey Perry gets the two front sportsman-like. I'm not sure if it's an instigator or not.